This is Red Wings Live. It's proudly presented, as always, by Arby's.
Here's Zetterberg quickly in front, comes over, down, sits back in front, down, look at it, scores!
Beautiful. Welcome inside the Fox Sports Detroit studios. Welcome to Red Wings Live. I'm John Keating with a former goaltender, Darren Elliott. Lake Superior State College, where apparently they don't have much to do this time of year besides shiver, annually comes out with a list of words or phrases that should be banished, they say. In tribute to last night's win in Edmonton, and on behalf of Red Wings Nation, they had the skill set to get their swag on amid the polar vortex, and the takeaway was a Wings victory. Bay, it was cray-cray. They deserved the win, tight or not, cray-cray or not.
They played well, and they had to shovel themselves out of something else you could do up in the UP right about now. They had to shovel themselves out of some harm's way when Edmonton was able to come back and score some goals, but I love the way they played last night. Start to finish, great road game, and it's been a formula for success all season long. Goaltending was there, special teams play was there.
Tough loss for Edmonton, but they're kind of used to tough losses. An ill-advised penalty in the later stages of the game led to a four-minute Red Wings power play, and that, kids, is your ball game.
That's it. Spearing. Yeah. 4 minutes, you put the Red Wings on the power play. They get three in all on the power play. They gave up one, but it was at the tail end of a 5-on-3. So overall, again, the formula was right there.
With 34 ticks left in Edmonton, the Wings outshot the Oilers 41-23 last night. The late goal, the last-minute gamer, leading to big smiles and big relief afterward in Edmonton.
You know, obviously need the points. I thought we played well, to be honest with you. Tough break when we shot it out of the far end of the rink there to go down 5-on-3. But I thought we did good things. And in the end, we got a power play there, and we're able to capitalize on the end to get the win. So, you know, a good win for our team.
So right back at it for your guys wearing the Red Wing wheel, playing back-to-back for just the fifth time this season. Montreal, crazily, cray-cray, has already played eight of them. Detroit is 2-1-1 in the second half. Meanwhile, the Flames have been off since Friday. Five nights rested. So who has, in your opinion, the edge here? A team that has played last night and will be a little weary, even though it's only an inch from Edmonton to Calgary, or a team that's been sitting around for five nights?
Well, I believe in this situation, the team that played last night has the advantage, especially in the first period. It's called the fourth period effect, at least by me. What that means is you're just rolling. You played last night, you're back in form, and you hope to make sure that you get to your game early. Don't let the other team, don't let them hang around. Make sure you establish early on. That's what the Red Wings would be looking to do.
Been sort of a strange trip for the Wings. They went to Vancouver and just kind of hung around waiting to play in Edmonton last night and right back at it in Calgary before they sort of passed by home on their way to Washington to play there on Saturday night. We knew that Peter Mrazek would start one of the two games in two nights. It's his first chance to play since December 23rd. Almost stunningly, I think, the Flames also going with their backup, Kari Ramo, who last played December 16th. I'll put this to you, Darren, gently. You know what it's like to be the backup, getting a turn and wearing some degree of pressure.
Yes, and they call them back-to-back games for a reason. The backup goalie gets them most times, especially on the road. They don't put an asterisk beside any of the numbers. Oh, you had to play in a back-to-back situation. Oh, you had to deal with travel. You have to play well. Peter Mrazek has done that. And Kari Ramo, you can see by those numbers, he's played one out of every three. That's a really good setup. He hasn't played well in his last three, so he's trying to reestablish. Peter Mrazek has been a battler. He's doing what a young goaltender is supposed to in that role.
All right, so Mrazek and Ramo, part of the game story tonight in Calgary. You know the drill. If there happens to be a Red Wings hat trick against Ramo tonight, your tomorrow could include a trip to Arby's. If it happens, bring a copy of the scoring summary, and they'll give you a free small order of curly fries. In a moment, we'll go Smokey the Bear on you. We'll focus on the Flames. It's been a long while since the Flames were a playoff team, but they're harboring those thoughts now, even as they endure some bumps along the way. Their story, explored next. Fox Sports Detroit Plus is brought to you by your local Toyota dealers. Visit buyatoyota.com. Toyota, Let's go places. And by Motor City Casino Hotel, a million miles away, right down the street. Wings and Flames coming up. Because of the decision by the Toronto Maple Leafs to fire their coach Randy Carlyle yesterday, Mike Babcock will find himself making kick saves most of the rest of the season to questions about his coaching future. He's not happy about it, but he's used to the deflections. It's our look around the league brought to you by Xfinity. Carlyle's predecessor in Toronto, Ron Wilson, went on the radio yesterday and called out Phil Kessel, stating it was 2 weeks on, 2 weeks off for the Leaf star. And on the day his coach was fired, Kessel was asked about it all.
The suggestions with the new organization, you're a difficult guy to coach. Is there any to that?
I don't think so. You know, that's a weird question for you to ask, so on a day like that, you know, your coach...
You're the best player on the team, and if the coach is got fired...
You think it's my fault? Is that what you're saying?
I'm saying you're,
is that what you're saying?
Saying that you're difficult to coach.
Is that what you're saying?
I'm asking a question. Are you difficult to coach, do you think?
I don't think so.
Okay.
I play, hey?
Thanks, Phil.
This guy's such an idiot here.
He's always been like this here.
Well, as you can imagine, there's been much speculation that the Leafs and team president Brendan Shanahan would be interested in Coach Mike Babcock, but the Wings don't believe those rumors will be a distraction. For Dana Wakiji's report and more Red Wings coverage, visit FoxSportsDetroit.com. Let's bring Darren back in. Your reaction to Phil Kessel's exchange with a member of the media in Toronto yesterday.
Well, to me, Phil Kessel is a tough player to defend at times because he does seem a little indifferent. If you will, both in his play, and he's certainly not a media darling, as you can see. But in this instance, that question, very pointed, unfair, I think, in given the circumstances especially. And I kind of side with Kessel in his reaction. I like the way he put two and two together. So he said, so it's my fault, huh? That's what you're trying to say?
So. Especially on the day that Randy Carlyle got inappropriate. All right, well, let's talk of the game that you're about to see, the Wings and Flames coming up, and we'll talk about the streaky Flames here. December 4th, they were just a point out of the top spot of the West. Then they lost eight in a row. Then they won four straight, but it's been a remarkable year for a team that has not been to the playoffs since 2009. And old friend Jiří Hudler is their leading scorer right now.
Yeah, he's been flashing the skill, doing an excellent job of the scoring. Johnny Gaudreau has been a revelation as a rookie, a challenge for the top frosh in the NHL this year. They have some guys up front, you know, that Sean Monahan's another kid that to build around. I think what's going on here with the likes of Jiří Hudler leading the way as a veteran player, that these guys are maybe a year or so ahead of where the expectations were, and that's what you start talking about. You know, boy, they're doing so well. And then when you compare them to their neighbors in Edmonton with what we talked about yesterday, it's like, why are they ahead of us when we've had all these top picks? Hard to say.
I'm getting my hair cut just like Jiří Hudler the next time I go in for a trim.
I'll pay for it.
Well, the difference maker in Calgary has been their defensive scoring. It is led by Mark Giordano, and it has been off the charts.
It really has been, and that's another thing that has changed in Edmonton, Calgary that's different than Edmonton. Their engine from the back end is high octane. Mark Giordano, the captain, he's really leading the charge for the Norris Division, 10 goals. TJ Brody leads them with the plus 18 and is the defense partner. You can see they both can score. You add in Dennis Wiseman, who has 10 goals as well, and suddenly you're getting boffo production from the blue line.
Giordano, a Norris Trophy candidate right now, you believe?
I believe so, yes.
Okay, well, they're led by Brian Burke, who came over from Toronto after he got the gate there to Calgary. He's a culture changer. He doesn't mind denting some feelings, does Mr. Burke. And Bob Hartley, his coach there, has found new life as he has bounced around a little bit, his third stop in the NHL.
Yeah, you know, both guys are hockey lifers, and I say that with endearing qualities all the way around. With Bob Hartley, he went to Switzerland, won a championship. I think he's learned a little bit. One thing he has learned, move the puck. He never used to let his defense do very much, unless the name was Ray Bourque, but that's another story. But the thing is, with Brian Burke, he wanted to change the culture. Bob Hartley has learned enough around the rinks. The culture's been changed. Calgary, tough team to play against.
All right, well, Darren is involved in this. There are literally hundreds of kids on hundreds of teams in the Little Caesars youth hockey programs. One team has a relatively well-known head coach. The year along as Chris Draper takes his kids to a hockey tournament in Toronto. When Red Wings Live continues on Fox Sports Detroit Plus, in a moment. High energy. Wings Live tonight is brought to you by ZotAuto.com, home of Chrysler, Jeep, Dodge, Ram, Ford, Toyota, and Scion. And by Flagstar Bank, a proud and official partner of the Detroit Red Wings. Let's be honest here. If it were up to Chris Draper, he'd still be playing for the Wings. He was one of those guys that had to be sort of nudged into retirement. That's how much he loved playing the game. And while he wears a coat and tie most days these days as an assistant to Ken Holland, you know he's never far from the rink, or a rink, helping to coach the next generation, perhaps, of Red Wings, his son Keenan included. Justin White went along on a Draper road trip.
Chris Draper hung up his skates 3 years ago, but he's still very close to the ice.
High energy. Let's go, play hard, have some fun.
Let's go, come on,
all right,
come on.
Be on that puck, all right? LC on three, ready? One, two, three.
LC!
Chris's son, Keenan, plays peewee hockey for Little Caesars. As the team's coach, Chris has the best seat in the house.
It's been a blast. Just to be able to share something that means so much to me, the game of hockey and the passion that I have for the sport. And now, you know, to see my son and the excitement that he has when he goes out there and plays, and he really enjoys it.
After an NHL career that spanned two decades, Chris no longer has to worry about missing Keenan's games. But the time they spend together away from the ice is something he cherishes just as much.
To me, the most fun I have is driving down to the rink and driving home after the rink. I remember that when I did that with my dad. And, you know, you just kind of sit in there and you just talk about it. You either talk about practice or you talk about the games.
When he was playing, I was his number one fan. And now when he watches me play, he's my number one fan.
Chris won four Stanley Cups with the Wings and was an original member of the Grind Line. He was often the fastest skater on the team and tries to impart his passion for the game to his players.
So you gotta walk to maybe make a shot, or you gotta get it down to the goal line. Curl with it, skate, create some separation. We got all that ice over there, okay? Come on, use your speed.
Before a game, he always says one word, and that word is relentless. He always wants us to be relentless on the forecheck and the backcheck, and he wants us to be a relentless team.
I think it's good because he tells us, like, a bunch of stories that he had, and it gets us motivated. And I think it's cool because the experiences we have.
In February, the Little Caesars O2s will get to experience something Chris did as a kid. They've qualified for the Pee Wee World Championships in Quebec, the oldest and most prestigious youth tournament in the world.
I played in it when I was, I played in it 2 years. I played in it when I was 11, I played when I was 12, so that was a long time ago. But some of the greatest players to play our game have played in it. Guys like Guy Lafleur and Mary Lemieux, you know, those guys have played in this tournament where these kids are gonna play at the Quebec Colisée. So the history is, it's unbelievable. They're excited about it, and I'm certainly excited about it as well.
The Quebec tournament is special, so Keenan and the rest of the kids will get to wear their Red Wings jerseys instead of the usual baby blue and orange. There's no telling who will be more excited, Keenan or his dad.
They take a lot of pride when they put that jersey on and they go out and they play hard. And for me, that's the fun part, is you know, going out and seeing those kids work hard, the way they play, the way they pass the puck, the way they skate, and just the development of these kids is it's very rewarding.
Justin White reporting. Keenan Draper, much like Chris Draper, very poised on camera and doesn't mind talking a little bit. Well, we give Darren Elliott all the glamour he can handle here, but his real job is director of Little Caesars Amateur Hockey, and those kids and their families really are what make Hockey Town Hockey Town.
And it goes back to the history. You heard about the pride in the jersey. 1968, the Elliots started the Little Caesars program. It's one of the most recognizable in the world, that baby blue and orange. And again, being part of that and now having the Red Wings involved with Chris Draper, going to the Pee Wee Quebec tournament. It's all about history. It's what Hockey Town is all about.
And it's hundreds and hundreds of kids, right? I mean, this is huge.
Yeah, there's 17 teams just at the AAA level with Little Caesars. Run the Little Caesars Amateur Hockey League. There's over 650 teams involved in that. You have the Little Wings program, over 250 entry-level players this year. That's a new program. So there's all kinds of grassroots initiatives.
All right, all those kids hoping to grow up to be NHL players and perhaps be like the Wings and the Flames who will play tonight in Calgary. And it went by quickly. It's easily said by those not doing all the skating and all the battling, but tonight is the halfway point of the season. How tough of a grader is Darren Elliott on what he's seen 40 games in? Find out next, report cards are issued when we come back. Put this up there with death and taxes and more Bruce Jenner plastic surgery. Pavel Datsyuk will factor in the scoring tonight. 42 games against Calgary in his career. Pavel has 43 points in the last six hockey seasons. He's averaging in 24 games 1.38 points per game versus the Flames. No one has lit them up more. He had three assists in the Wings 3-2 win the last time they played Calgary. Tonight's game gets the Wings halfway home. Right now, they're a playoff team. The top three teams in each division are automatics, and the Wings are third right now behind Montreal and Tampa Bay. And now, 6 points up on the fourth place Leafs. And at the midpoint, we do some reflecting. So let's grade the Wings first half. And the mean teacher you always hated in school is Mr. Elliott. You have report cards for us?
I do. And we're going to start at when they have the puck. Offense, 2.8 goals per game. Okay, I give them a B minus, mostly because they're only plus six in terms of the goal differential skating at even strength. So that's there's room for improvement there, certainly. More production from the blue line would be a big help. Look at the defense. Can't get much better than that. 2.4 goals against per game. Again, I give them the minus. The little minus are just because at even strength, again,
because you're tough.
Save percentage. The save percentage is a little bit low. Special teams, A plus. There's only four teams: Vancouver, Pittsburgh, and Detroit. With the both teams, the special teams in the top 10, and the goaltending, Jimmy Howard. That should be an A-plus, if not for the shootouts, and that's where he gets the A-minus. But he's been fantastic this season. Overall, what a fine start to the season. B-plus, and it's not higher than that because they're third in the division.
All right, quick thought on tonight's game. As the Wings get set to go up against the Flames, the team they don't see all that often, haven't seen for a year.
Well, no, you better be ready to play. A team is really rusty. They haven't played since Friday.
Yeah.
Team that played last night, get after them.
All right, well, the Flames have been one of the better stories in the league this year. We'll get you to the Saddle Dome next, where Trevor Thompson will take over. He will further tee up tonight's tilt via a conversation with Wings defenseman Danny DeKeyser, whose game is really growing. Red Wings Live continues on a chilly night from Alberta and from here in Hockey Town as well.
Welcome to the Scotiabank Saddle Dome in Calgary, where the Wings will take on the Flames here tonight, the second end of a back-to-back, looking for back-to-back wins. Last night, paced by Kyle Quincy, second of the year, as they got the 4-2 win over the Oilers. Tonight, they'll try to make it back-to-back wins as they entertain the Flames. And while we were in Edmonton, Red Wings head coach Mike Babcock said his top pair of defensemen all year long have been Kyle Quincy and his partner Danny DeKeyser. A little earlier, I asked Danny why these two have complemented each other so well all year long.
I think we're just, you know, getting more and more comfortable with each other each and every night. It just kind of grows with confidence, and the more you play with guys, you know, the more comfortable you're going to get with playing with that guy out on the ice. So I think you kind of gain that chemistry over the course of, you know, several months.
Today you guys will be in tough with a team that really scores a lot from the back end. They produce a lot of offense on their back end, four guys with 22 points or more. How does that challenge you guys in your defensive end tonight?
Well, we're going to have to be on top of our game. You know, we're just going to have to try to limit their speed coming through the neutral zone, try to cut them off when we can. And when we do get chances to break out, we got to execute on first passes and not give them second chances to stay in the zone and create offense.
Knowing that they're going to try and generate some offense from behind, how much more important does that mean that you guys stick to your game plan and what you want to do to execute in your own end especially?
Well, it's going to be big for us. Like I said, we can't have neutral zone turnovers or turnovers at our blue line, things like that. We got to really make sure we're careful with the puck and get it out when we can, and you know, make sure we're pressuring them in our D zone and not giving them time and space.
Good luck tonight. Thanks for this, Dan.
Thank you.
So the Flames are big time producers on their back end, but tonight may it be a Red Wing blue liner who's your player of the games. Sponsored by McDonald's single, double, triple cheeseburger. Will it be Danny DeKeyser? Will it be Kyle Quincy, Nick Cromwell, or another blue liner? We'll find out. You can tune in to the postgame edition of Red Wings Live to find out who the winner is later on tonight. When we come back to Calgary, Ken Daniels and Chris Osgood will have puck drop as the Wings try to make it back-to-back wins here in Alberta.